myself Naveen Kumar Chaudhary. Today I want to discuss the chapter Nutrition in Animals, chapter number 2, class 7, day 3. Yesterday it was discussed by me the preparing of food, any mode of preparing food by the animals and digest. Today I want topic digestion in humans. Yesterday it was also discussed that the digestive tract, about the digestive tract, which begins at the buccal cavity and ends at the anus. So today you can see in this figure also human digestive system. Today I want to discuss about the ingestion. First we take the food by our hand to the mouth, into the mouth. That food is break and chew and grind it by our teeth. The chewing mixes the small pieces of food with saliva. Or this digestion of food is called the mechanical digestion. Each tooth is present in a separate socket in the gums, or that is the white and hardest substances called teeth in our mouth, which has the enamel. Our teeth are of different shapes and size and carry out different types of functions based on their structure. These are the incisors called cutting teeth, canines, tearing teeth, premolars, grinding teeth, and molars, that is also the grinding teeth. We have the temporary and permanent set of teeth. In human being, the teeth grow twice. The temporary set of teeth grow when the child is in the age of 6 months to 8 years. That is also called the milk teeth. The number of these teeth are the 20, 10 in the upper jaw and 10 in the lower jaw. When these teeth are fall out, the second set of teeth is called the permanent teeth, that are in number of 32, 16 in the upper jaw and 16 in the lower jaw. Second is the tongue. The tongue is a fleshy muscular organ attached at the back to the floor of the buccal cavity. It is free in the front and can be moved in all directions. It performs to mix saliva with food. It helps in pushing and thus swelling of food into the food pipe, and it also helps in getting the different tastes of food because it has the several taste buds which taste the food in salty, sour, bitter and sweet. And it also enables us to speak. Number three is the salivary gland. These glands produce saliva. Saliva contains an enzyme called amylase that breaks down the starch present in the food into sugars. It also makes the food wet and slimy so that it can be easily swallowed. The pharynx and oesophagus. Number three is the stomach. The food goes to the stomach. It is a shape of J-shaped thick walled organ present on the left side of the abdomen. And it is the widest part of the alimentary canal. The inner wall of the stomach contains gastric glands. These glands secretes gastric or digestive juice, which contain three substances, the hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. Number four, the small intestine. This is the largest part of the alimentary canal. It is about 7.5 meters long and arranged in the form of a coil. It receives secretion form from two glands, the liver and pancreas. The wall of the intestine also secretes digestive juices called intestinal juices. That's all.